Assalamu alaikum and good morning. So today we will learn about the steady state error, which is the last part of the chapter number 4. Okay, this table shows several test waveform or input R of T to evaluate the steady state error. Okay, the first row shows the unit step waveform or unit step input, where if you do the Laplace transform of the unit step, you will get 1 over s. Okay. The second row is a ramp function or ramp waveform. Okay. And in the time function, r of t is equals to t. Okay. And if you do the Laplace transform of t, you will get a 1 over s squared. Okay. And the last one is a parabola waveform or parabola input. Okay, so in the time function, you will get this 0.5 t to the power of 2. And if you do the Laplace transform, you will get 1 over s to the power of 3. Okay, so all these three waveform or three inputs will be used to evaluate the steady state error. Okay, next we go for the steady state error analysis. Okay, here there are two types. Okay, the first one, the first block diagram here is a block diagram with a unity feedback where h of s is equals to 1. And then the second block diagram is a non-unity feedback where h of s is not equals to 1. Okay. Alright, according to the previous plot diagram, for unity feedback system, the error is equals to e of s equals to r of s minus c of s. It is a system error. For a non-unity feedback system, e of s is equals to r of s minus h of s c of s. Okay, this is the actuating error. Consider the h of s. Okay, let's just focus on the unity feedback system. Consider the unity feedback system as shown in the previous slide. We can get the system error e of s, which is equals to r of s minus c of s. Okay, this we put as equation 1. Then, as you already know, we also have calculated many times before this. You can find, based on the previous block diagram, you can find the complete transfer function C of S over R of S. So, this is shown in this equation number 2, where here the transfer function G of S over 1 plus G of S multiply with R of S. Okay. So this we already known in the previous lecture. So next, we substitute equation number 2 into equation number 1. So what happened is that now E of S is equals to R of S minus, this is a C of S. Okay, so we simplify, then we get this equation number 3. Okay, so next we will learn on how to find the steady state error. So the equation of a steady state error is given by ESS in a bracket infinity. This equation, ESS is actually equals to limit t goes to infinity e of t. So basically we want to know what happened to the error when t goes to infinity. And if we convert this time domain equation to the Laplace domain, we will get the limit where s goes to 0 as e of s. So basically, we will use the e of s in the previous slide, and we will see what happened to the steady state error with regards to the three types of inputs. Okay, first, let's look on the step input. If r of s equals to 1 over s, okay, then the steady state error is equals to 1 over 1 plus limit s goes to 0 g of s, which is equals to 1 over 1 plus kp. Okay, so this is the formula of the steady state error if the state input is applied. Okay, so next is the ramp input. So the formula is as follows. ESS equals to 1 over limit s goes to 0 s gs. Okay, so please notice the difference. And it is equals to 1 over kv. So kv is a limit s goes to 0 s gs. And the last one is the parabolic input. R of s equals to 1 over s to the power of 3. So the steady state error for this type of input is equals to 1 over limit s goes to 0 s square g of s. Okay, this is equals to 1 over ka. Okay, so for the simplification, you just can memorize all these three formulas for three types of input in order to calculate the steady state error. Okay, let's go for the example or exercise number one. Determine the steady state error for the following inputs for the system shown below. Okay, first we have the step input RT equals to U of T. Then we have a ramp input RT equals to T of T U T. Then we have the parabolic input RT equals to 2 square U of T. Okay, and we give you this transfer function. Okay, as for the solution, you can use the previous formula. For the step input, RT equals to UT, KP is equals to 20. Then steady state error is 1 over 1 plus 20, which is 0.048. Then for the ramp input, RT equals to TUT, KV, you will find that it is equals to 0. Then steady state error is 1 divided by 0. And you will get infinity. Same goes to parabolic input. Ka is equals to 0. Then steady state error is equals to infinity. Okay, so please practice and find more question on the how to calculate the steady state error. I think that's all for the steady state error lecture. Thank you very much.